The gain on the association's investments in 2016 was at an all-time high of $688,000, a gain over the one-year period of approximately 13%. The surplus from operations in 2016 was $451,000. The association is well positioned financially to support implementation of a new IT system this year and any future capital investments like the renewal of the website and keeping the defined benefit pension plan solvent. Council and OAB, understandably so, there's been a significant amount of volunteer and staff time that goes into supporting Council and OAB meetings. Coordination of meetings, agendas, selection of venues, minutes, preparation of reports and motions for review prior to the meetings to ensure members of these boards have the information they need to make well-informed decisions all takes time and commitment to deliver effectively. Volunteers and staff are to be commended for a job well done when it comes to the affairs of these boards. The member retention program has been in place for more than 9 years and continues to bring back a large percentage of members who have been resigned for not paying their membership dues. The association has retained a group that calls the resigned members to remind them that their membership has lapsed and to encourage them to renew. Over the past year, an average of 60% of certified and associate members who were contacted through this program have renewed their membership. Another program to assist in retaining college students after graduation was put in place 2 years ago. This program offers graduating students in their first and second year after graduation reduced fees of $50. We will know if this program is encouraging more graduates to remain members of OSET in the third year after graduation when they will be billed for their full amount of membership dues. This will occur in the latter part of next year for the first group of graduates, so stay tuned for the results in 2018. As you may have heard, as you did hear from Greg this morning, the association will lose four of its staff to retirement this year. Three of those retirements are in finance and administration, and the other in AIDO. This will afford the association's senior management team the opportunity to evaluate upcoming staffing needs given the introduction of new technology and future skills requirements. Our sincere thanks goes out to all four retirees for their many years of service, and we welcome and offer our support to the employees that are replacing them. This concludes my report on finance and administration. I'd like to switch gears now and provide you with an update on the association's government relations activities in my capacity as chair of that committee. A priority established by OSET Council is to advance a comprehensive government relations effort at Queen's Park to advance member initiatives and interests. The Government Relations Committee is targeting activities in support of OSET's qualified persons. Qualified person activities include maintaining vigilance in monitoring and responding to qualified person issues as they arise in order to support our members and follow up on information required and common interests, as well as to ensure OSET members are qualified to perform job-related skills in the workplace, are not denied rights that are important to their careers and livelihood. Specifically this year, OSET met with the Ministry of Environment and Climate Change, as well as the Environmental Commissioner, to present our objectives to the proposed regulation amendments that would affect our members. During the past year, OSET has had productive meetings and attended events with a number of organizations, including the Ministry of Education, the Canadian Manufacturers and Exporters, the Ontario College of Trades, the Ministry of Environment and Climate Change, the Ontario Ministry of Transportation, and the Association of Registered Interior Designers of Ontario, with the purpose of sharing information and working toward common goals. OSET regularly attended various government functions and MPP events to discuss the benefits of certification, our role within industry and the public, and the relevance of our professional association, meeting more than 20 MPPs. Government relations is a priority for our association, and during my time as chair of the Government Relations Committee, I have found it to be a fascinating and a rewarding experience representing OSET members and raising the profile and the contribution that we make among our elected officials and industry stakeholders. Thank you.